been out of her life for 3 years, and but she's my hope. She's never given up on me. So it's a great opportunity for a lot of women out there. And all I have to say is thank you.
That's just one of the hundreds of inmates getting a new start on life after being part of the largest single-day commutation of prisoners in U.S. history.
Well, now 3 days into life beyond bars, we checked back in with Elaine Lemus. News 4's Jessica Bruno met her when she walked out of prison, a free woman, on Monday, and caught up with her again today.
For Lana Lemus, this key.
This is my little house.
And house.
I'm gonna put a light in and put my couch right here. And
are more than what meets the eye.
Being able to just open the door to your own house. People take that for granted. They don't realize what they have.
Something Lemus says she learned during her 3 years incarcerated at Cape Bernard Correctional Center. That's where we first met on Monday when she walked away a free woman, greeted by her daughter Ivy with an emotional embrace.
God's had his hand on me for years, and I didn't really believe that I would get this second chance.
That second chance, part of the nation's largest single-day commutation, dating back to 2016, when voters approved State Question 780. Criminal justice reform becoming a reality Friday when the governor commuted over 500 sentences for simple possession crimes that are now considered misdemeanors.
The governor doing this, it brings all of us back to our family, you know, whenever we get locked up, our parents get locked up too. Our parents, our family, the people that care about us, it kills them.
And Lemus says it's not only quality time with family and her own place, but also the little things she's cherishing.
Being able to walk into a store and just, I walked to Walgreens this morning, I was just looking around. Hi, ma'am, can I help you? No, I just want to look at stuff. Everything around us is a blessing, and nobody sees that.
In Southeast Oklahoma City, Jessica Bruno, Oklahoma's News 4.
Well, she admits she's experienced some unexpected problems. She's having trouble sleeping. She's not used to all the noises you don't have in prison, like cars driving by and, of all things, birds chirping.